In this lesson, we'll cover on how to interpret the details of a flow record. We'll look at the base information associated with every flow record, as well as, for those records for which we've captured payload, how to interpret what we would call layer 7 information. Like we normalize event records into a common log file format, we also do this with flow information. The network event record provides you a nice summary view of a flow. In this case, you'll see at the top which protocol was seen, which application was observed and matched, the overall magnitude associated with the flow record, as well as information about the first time we saw packets associated with this flow. It's important to read the event description field. This describes how we determined which application was observed. In this particular case, you'll see that application was detected by state-based decoding. That is, there is a component within QRadar that observed how the particular source and destination interacted and to determine that this was actually, in fact, an HTTP interaction. You'll also observe that there are various fields that deal with HTTP header information. If that information is available to us, we can extract it and put it into those fields. You'll notice for this particular record, we only extracted the HTTP version number. The source and destination information section provide clues as to source IP, destination IP, source port, and destination port. In addition, since we're dealing with network communications, we'll also see what flags were set on the particular packets, is there any quality of service information, and as well as the total number of packets and bytes associated with this session. QRadar can consume netflow records from routers, switches, firewalls, and intrusion prevention systems. It can also capture flow information by using its own QFlow appliances. The benefit of using a QFlow appliance is that in addition to the normal meta information that you would find in the flow record, we can also extract payload. If payload has been extracted for a flow record, you'll see it here in the payload section. You'll not only see the payload from the source, as well as any response generated by the destination. In this particular case, we're dealing with an HTTP interaction. So in the source payload section, we actually see the HTTP GET as well as the corresponding URL. Then in the destination payload, we actually see the response back from the web server. By default, QRadar only captures the first 64 bytes of payload. This can be increased by your administrator. Towards the bottom of the flow record, you'll see the additional information section. You'll see which particular rules this flow would have triggered on, as well as partially matched. You also see annotations which deal with how did the magnitude associated with this particular flow get adjusted based on weightings of source and destination networks. You also see a column called the flow direction. Flow direction is important. In this case, we're dealing with traffic that's going from L, which is local, to R, which is remote, meaning outbound traffic. In some cases, you may see multiple entries for the flow source interface. That may be because we've received flow records dealing with this interaction from multiple systems that can detect and generate flow records.